Hi everyone, Anthony Morganti here. Recently, I received an email from a photographer asking me if there were a way, using Lightroom, that they could blur out the face of a person that happened to be in a photo. Specifically, they were at an event and they took a picture of their children. And behind their children were some other kids whose faces could be recognized. They wanted to post the picture online, but they first wanted to blur out the faces of the kids in the background. Well, you really can't do that in Lightroom, but it's very easy to do in Photoshop. So I'm going to show you how to do it today using Photoshop. We're going to start out in Lightroom, like I assume that photographer that emailed me will be starting out. And then we're going to send the image from Lightroom, this specific image, it's a stock image. We're going to send it into Photoshop and blur out the face of the little girl. All right, to do that, we're just going to right-click right on the image and go down to Edit In and over to Edit in Adobe Photoshop 2022. Now we have three options. You can edit a copy with Lightroom Adjustments, edit a copy, or edit the original. I don't want to edit the original. I like to keep that so that I always have the original intact. We'll have a second image that will have the blurred out face in it. And I'm going to edit a copy with Lightroom Adjustments. And we'll click Edit. And Lightroom will create that file and it will open that file up into Photoshop. Now, like many things in Photoshop, there's several different ways you could do this. I'm going to show you probably a way that is rather uncommon, but I think it is most effective and it is still very easy to do. Now, what we're going to do first is we're going to duplicate the background layer by hitting Command or Control J. So we're going to do all our work on the new layer. Next, we want to use something called Quick Mask, but your Photoshop may not be showing the Quick Mask tool in the toolbar. It's right here. It's this little rectangle with a circle in the middle of it. Now, if you don't see that here, what you need to do is go up to the toolbar properties. That's under the Edit menu, and it's down here, Toolbar. Then right here, Show, and you can see right here is the Quick Mask icon. Just click on that to make sure that it is showing in the toolbar like it is. Now, after you have it showing in the toolbar, we need to edit one of its settings. So double-click on it, and when you do, you'll come up with Quick Mask Options. Now, by default, it's going to say that the color indicates the masked areas. What you need to do is change that to the color indicates the selected areas. So make sure that that is changed to selected areas like mine is. You could leave the opacity at 50% and click OK. Now next, we're going to turn the Quick Mask on. Just click on it and you'll see when it's on, it has a solid circle in the middle. When it's off, it has just an outline of a circle in the middle. Once it's on, you need to get a brush. Hit the B key for the brush tool. It's right here. Here's the brush tool. And make sure that you're painting in black. So if you don't see black as the foreground swatch, just hit the X key on your keyboard and it will swap the swatches. So black is foreground. Now what we're going to do is we're going to be painting this Quick Mask over the little girl's face. I'm going to get a larger brush by hitting the right bracket key. Now you may want to go back up to the top here and go to the brush settings and make sure hardness is somewhere in the middle. That will work pretty well for most faces. Then come in and just paint. And you'll notice now even though I have a black brush, it's painting and it's putting a red overlay on. That's because we're using Quick Mask. We're going to blur out the little girl's face. So we'll come in and just like that, we'll put this overlay on her face. Maybe over there. Okay. Now if you had another person that you wanted to blur out, whose face you wanted to blur out as well, just paint on their face. So we painted on the first face, paint on the second face, paint on the third face, do it all at once. We're only doing one person in this image, so I'm good. Next, we're going to come here and turn off Quick Mask by just clicking on it again. And when I do that, you'll see that we have a selection now. You can see that there's marching ants on the little girl's face. Now, there's a couple different ways we could blur it out. We could just blur it out or we could pixelate it. Let's do the blur out part first. We'll go up to Filter, then down to Blur, and then over to Gaussian Blur. And you can see there's a little bit of blur. Make sure that the preview checkbox is checked and you'll see it over here. But you could turn it up and just blur out the face to any amount you want. So that's one way to do it. I'm going to hit cancel and I'm going to show you another way is we could pixelate the face. To do that, we have the selection. go up to Filter, down to Pixelate, and then over to Mosaic. And there, we have a similar box. Make sure that preview checkbox is checked. And we could put this kind of mosaic look on there, something like that. And then when you're done with either the Gaussian blur or the mosaic pixelization, just click OK. Now you'll still have those marching ants on there. You could get rid of that by hitting Command or Control D for deselect. And there, we just blurred out the little girl's face. When you're done, what I do is we want to save this back into Lightroom, right? What I do though is I just go to Photoshop, quit Photoshop. You just quit Photoshop on a Windows computer like you normally would. And make sure you click on Save. That is important. So click on Save, and it will save that image, and then we'll be back in Lightroom. And once we're back in Lightroom, we'll have two images. We'll have the original image, which is unscathed, right? Nothing was done to that. And then we have the image that has the pixelated face, and it's not updating. There it is. There it updated. All right, there's the pixelated face, and there is the unscathed image. So that's how you go about blurring out or pixelating the face of a person using Photoshop. Thank you, everyone who watches my videos. I really do appreciate it. Talk to you guys soon.